New documents obtained from the Nebo and Alpine school districts in the state of Utah prove beyond a shadow of a doubt that there is no level of education, of government education, that your family and your children are safe from the sodomite supremacy indoctrination on today's Tree of Liberty Society program. On today's program, we are going to be delving into new documents that have been made public from Utah school districts. So Utah, right? We would never think that Utah, especially on the local level school districts, in traditionally rural areas that are considered to be very, very conservative, would be having their school districts pushing down the sodomite supremacy agenda down children and also harming families by preventing parents from knowing where their children are at on this issue. And if their children are working on wanting to be identified as a different gender than they actually are. And so these school districts are promoting policies and programs that will hide information from the parents of children on today's program. And it'll be these documents are going to be on our website, thetreeoflibertysociety.com, treeoflibertysociety.com. Links in the description if you're not watching the video on the website. Encourage you to always do so, because this channel could be taken down at any time. This video could be taken down at any time. And if you want to make sure that you do not miss another program, you need to go to thetreeoflibertysociety.com and sign up for email alerts or text alerts. Make sure your emails don't go into junk mail. And that way, no matter what happens on any of the platforms, that you are still getting all of the up-to-date information, including the documents that I am going to be talking about and covering on today's program. It's very shocking for those of you that are not in the state of Utah. If this can happen in these two school districts, of all the school districts in the country, it can happen literally anywhere. I think it's going to blow your mind, some of the information that is going on in these school districts that we have here. We have Alpine School District, where they're kind of excusing and they're making kind of loopholes for administrators and teachers to be able to hide information from parents. If you remember just a couple of years ago, parents were being accused of being terrorists for being involved in their, children's education, the government school system. That's what they think of you. And it's not just on the federal level. This is on the local level. People in the state of Utah even were arrested for being involved in their children's government school education. And so that should tell us also that it's time. Even Natalie Klein on the state school board has said that, it's time to get your kids out of government schools. It's not safe on many, many levels, spiritually, academically, mentally, on any level that you can think of. It is not safe to be in government schools. Do what you can, make any sacrifice you can to get your kids out of government schools. And if this doesn't convince you, I don't know what will. Maybe later on I'll get into some of my own experience working in government schools and many years ago and what happened there. Just, even talking about many years ago, let alone what's going on right now. But from a document from the Alpine School District, their official document. It says there is no requirement under the law to report the gender identity to a parent or guardian unless the student is asking for a change to their educational record or program, such as to be referred by a student in a different name than the name on records or pronouns. So if they want to be identified as a different gender, if they are giving their pronouns, if they are dressing in certain ways, there's no requirement. They're telling them that they don't have to tell their parents. Emphasizing the point, quote, due to safety concerns, there may be circumstances wherein students' parents or guardians should not be contacted. Please work with the school counselors, school workers, psychologists, and the Division of Child and Family Services under these circumstances. So this is a conspiracy between CPS, between the psychologists, social workers, school counselors, and teachers and school administrators to hide information from parents about their child Generally, a parent or guardian is already aware of their student's gender identity and transition status. If not, school personnel should work closely with the student to assess barriers to parental participation and to consider the health, well-being, and safety of the student prior to parent notification. Well-being, meaning mental health. So if a kid says, "Oh, I'm going to get in trouble," then a teacher is going to hide this information from their parents. The document explains that the age of the student will impact the school's involvement of parents. However, parental participation is not required for a student to request accommodation. Students as young as sixth grade can request gender identity accommodations without parental knowledge. Sixth grade, a 12-year-old, 11-year-old, sometimes a 10-year-old, mostly 11-year-olds, can now keep this information from their parents with the assistance of the school. When I was around this age, our school had a what was called Peace Day. And I show up to school for Peace Day wearing my father's army camouflage to school. And they didn't find it very humorous. So they got a phone call from my parents got a phone call from the school, and I was sent home immediately to change my clothes. But, if I was around today and it was trans, you know, if I was went to school in a mini skirt and in a tank top, then the school and I said, "Oh, no, don't please don't tell my parents." They would protect. They would keep that a secret from my parents. It's just insanity. It's so wicked and so evil. Now let's go to the Nebo School District. And what are they doing? So Nebo, for those of you that are not aware of where Nebo is, Nebo, the school district is in Juab County, which is roughly a half an hour, 45, you know, half an hour south of Provo, Utah. It is a very rural area. There is no big cities in the Nebo School District. It is farmland and, traditional values type of individuals. And this is what their school district, their local school district, local control supposedly, is getting your family to, doing to hide your child and their transgender and sodomite supremacy mindset is from their parents. From the Nebo School District, they have a document that was recently obtained by parents through a state version of the Freedom of Information Act that says when students want to go by a different preferred pronouns or names, that the presentation asks and explains to ask the students if they want their parents involved. This is often the first step in transitioning from one gender to another. Consider asking the student if he/she would like is to schedule a meeting with parents to discuss other issues that may arise and to ensure that there is a plan in place to help the student feel safe. The presentation then goes on to explain that the students should then be addressed according to their preferred pronouns, addressing them by their delusions. So if they're a cat, if they are, a unicorn, whatever it is, they're supposed to encourage that as opposed to helping them overcome it. When discussing if parents should be notified, the presentation states that parents only need to be notified if there is a serious threat to the well-being of the student, without the parents knowing about it. Quote, knowledge of a student's gender identity or sexual orientation alone does not likely constitute a serious threat. Unless the student is being bullied on the basis of his gender identity or sexual orientation, it is unlikely that you can establish a serious threat to a student's well-being, even if you know the student's parents and know that the student's parents would not approve. So if you know that the student's parents will not approve of what's going on and of their transition of identifying from what they are to what they are not, you're not supposed to tell them, because it's only to be told is if there is a serious threat to them. Then it has to be, otherwise it has to be kept a secret. So the schools are a place where your children and are getting into things that your values that your family do not support, and that the school district, the school that you're sending your children to be educated on, the reading, writing, and arithmetic, and they are being part of the cover-up to hide things from you as a parent that just a short time ago you would have been involved with to help correct. The presentation adds regarding parental knowledge Quote, the ACLU is very protective of a student's right to privacy in his or her sexuality. So because of this, communist organization is saying that they are very sensitive and they want to protect, so-called protect a minor. Minors can't make decisions. Minors can't get tattoos. Minors can't get credit cards. Minors can't get home loans. But, you know, we're going to send them along the path to genital mutilation. Staff are presented with several scenarios of students identifying as transgender and how to handle those situations. They are then provided with a document called Practical Tips for Interacting with Transgender Students. They have a list of definitions and they have social transition, kind of explain the difference between that and medical transition. They have listing common issues. They have telling parents. Note that the ACLU is very protective of a student's right. If a school employee believes that a situation exists which presents a serious threat to the well-being of a student, the employee must notify the parents without delay. Other than a threatening situation, volunteering known information about a student's sexuality with parents is not advised. Okay, so not only they're saying it's do not tell them. It's not advised. It's code for don't tell them. Because we're going to get a lawsuit from the ACLU if you do. So they need to consider the following determinations about talking to parents. That's the age of the student, whether the student is being bullied, student requests, and knowledge of parents' relationship with students. What if a parent asks to be called a preferred pronoun and parents object? If the parent's under student is 18, the parent's request, unless the student is under 18, the parent's request should govern. But because they were already told, there's kind of like this doublespeak where if they are, you know, they're not told about it, then there's no way for me to know what I should do. And they're told that if there's no violence going on, then the parents should not be told what's going on. Now, this is going to be something that changed. We just covered this in a video a couple of weeks ago. The next part about school records. In Utah, official school records must include information found on the student's birth certificate. But now with state law, you can alter state record and you can change the birth certificate to say that your gender, not just your sex, your gender is not what you are. So you can falsify that. Under FERPA, a parent may request a school to amend the student's record, including the name on the records. But it's ultimately up to the school whether the request is granted. School bathroom and locker rooms. So they're opening up the door here in Nebo, in farmland country, for a man in the school, another 16-year-old boy in your daughter's school, to go in the locker room and the bathrooms with them and change with them. It says that school bathrooms, Nebo's position is to review each matter on a case-by-case basis. So they're saying that they will allow it. Many schools provide a unisex bathroom, but that's not about a changing room. And it also explicitly says that access should not be controlled by other students or parents' comfort level regarding the access. So what everybody's comfortable with and what's, you know, of course, right in the situation is not going to be considered. Okay, it says do not jump to the answer, like for overnight trips, sporting events, cheerleading things, just school trips. It says do not jump to the thing of separating people by their, you know, by their genitalia. Specifically, they're getting down to that because gender and sex now are social constructs, supposedly. And so now they're going to get into if your son is identifying or if a boy is identifying as a girl, that and he, you know, feels uncomfortable that he's being forced to be put with the other boys and he wants to, you know, sleep overnight in a hotel room with other girls, we're going to have to handle this by a case-by-case basis. We shouldn't just exclude them. You know, we got to ask them how they, you know, where do they feel comfortable according to this document. And there are just a ton of other issues in these documents. There are several documents that we're going to be putting on our website that you've got to check out. It is high time that parents do whatever they can to protect their children by removing this, reforming the system, right? We have on the state school board in the state of Utah, three or four individuals that ran on the idea that they were protecting families, that they were preserving the Constitution and making sure that traditional values were preserved in Utah schools, whereas only, you know, all of them, you know, there's only one that's, you know, even pretended to come out and say that they are actually standing for these things and gotten in trouble from the public eye for it. The other individuals that ran on these things are actually condemning the individual that came out and supports traditional and making sure that we actually, base on science of actual sex and gender is a defined term, chromosomal, not just based on, what kind of plastic surgery you can and cannot get. And so on the in the state like Utah, children are not getting protected. Women are not getting protected. Girls are not being protected. On the local level, we can see as well, they are not being protected. Women and girls are in danger in public institutions all over the country. And the best that we can do right now is to protect them by removing them. Reforming them is like reforming the mafia. That's just not that it's not giving up, it's recognizing the situation that you're in and what it is that we're dealing with. We need to get our kids out of government school at all costs. Charter schools are government schools. Get your kids out of government schools at all costs. If this can happen in Nebo, this can happen anywhere. And you're not going to know about it. In fact, I think that's a good segue into my own experience. My own family has a long history of teaching in government schools. I am very much anti-government school, but in favor of course, education. My teacher is a government, my, what did I say? My sister is a government school teacher, and my aunt was a lifelong government school teacher. My mother-in-law worked for the school districts, and as I became aware of the problems with government schools, I wanted to make sure that my children were not going to be a part of that. And so many years ago, I actually got a job working as a substitute teacher's assistant in schools. And so that I could see firsthand from kindergarten all the way up to 12th grade what was happening in government schools. And you would not believe, and the parents, of course, they're not going to be notified about what's going on because just as we see today with Utah school districts, even in rural areas, they are hiding this information from parents. These things were not, of course, told. You had as young as kindergarten and first grade of a teacher rubbing crystals on the kids to make sure that they were learning as best as they could, all the way up to high school where they were shown a slideshow presentation of photographs, not drawings, photographs of every, now, hear my word, every sex act, natural or unnatural, was photographed and shown to these minors. Photographs. And when I took this, wanted to expose this to the local school district, what happened? Well, they thought it was the janitor that did it. I didn't want the janitor to get in trouble for what I did. And so I confessed, right?
Do you confess? Do you confess?
And I was immediately taken to the superintendent of schools in the school district that I was in. And I was told that this, could never happen again. And that when I returned to the classroom, the teacher herself told me that if this happened again, she could not, quote, guarantee my protection. Okay? This is in the classroom level. Now, this is not to say there aren't, people that consider themselves to be good teachers, like good politicians, right? They're nice guys, right? Now, my student's teacher is very nice. Well, they're being brainwashed. They're being trained in certain ways. They're being trained to keep things from students. They're being trained to teach this, to say the thing that you, the parent, are a danger to the children and can cause psychological harm to them. And so with all of this going on, we have a clear, established a doctrine that the schools are a threat to parents and their ability to be the final arbiter of what your children learn and are being indoctrinated into you. And if we think that just spending a couple of hours a day after school is going to, fix that, it doesn't match the amount of hours that they're being indoctrinated. It doesn't match the hours in addition to with the homework that they're being indoctrinated with. And then if it's so wrong, why do you keep sending me there, mom and dad? If everything I'm learning needs to be untaught when I get home, am I not worthy enough to, be protected from such nonsense? Am I not worthy enough to be taught the truth all the time? It's something, that these things are things that our children are going to understand and they're going to think about and ask themselves. And so it's essential that we show our children by not just word, but deed, how important they really are to us. Now that we understand what's going on, you know, you shun these people in the community that are hiding this stuff from you as parents. You do not treat them as legitimate instructors of your children. You do not treat them as legitimate leaders in your community. You remove all semblance of legitimacy from them, and you protect your children at all costs. This is one of the steps that we talk about in our books, Invasion, because education is one of the keys of establishing the conspiracy as a dominant force in your community. And so I encourage you to get Invasion books, volume 1 and 2. We've got a great bundle package going on. I encourage you to get that to learn more about what's really going on and about what you can do about it right at thetreeoflibertysociety.com. And we'll see you next time.